And as I'm looking at the ducks, look, you can see. You can see the heat of the ducks themselves. Mundungus Fletcher, he's just soaking it up. Not a care in the world. That's so dumb. Just a little bit ago, as I was coming in to check on the ducks, I was walking back here and I noticed what looked like the ducks had gotten out of the pen somehow, and I sort of freaked out. But then as I got closer, I realized they were turkeys. There were like a whole bunch of wild turkeys just sort of wandering around, pecking around. My guess is that they are probably feeding on the leftover grain from the ducks right now, because every time I dump the water from the ducks, there's usually mashed up, wetted down grain that's left over. It's kind of cool though. You can see their tracks, right? See like all these little scratchy lines all around through here. Somebody did a loop over there. They were wandering over by the barn here. See it? Those are clearly turkey tracks. I imagine that this is gonna be a really tough winter for the wildlife around here. We had such an early winter. I mean, we got a pretty good snowfall in October, and we've been pretty much completely covered in snow since, I don't know, early November. And it's been cold. And so I can't imagine that the wildlife, whether they're deer or turkey or bear or whatever it is, got their fill of the things that they probably wanted. And so I wouldn't be surprised if we see a lot of wildlife pressure here around the ducks, especially because this is the first year that they're here, and especially because they're going to be a source of grain for other animals. So as we keep our ducks, we are using a deep litter bedding method for our duck house. Deep litter bedding is when you basically allow your animals to stay in a barn or a coop of some sort, and they will poop and spread their manure all over, you know, straw and hay, and then you keep piling on fresh straw and hay, and occasionally you turn it. The theory with deep litter bedding is that as you pile on more fresh material, the older material is going to start to decompose and compost. That compost is supposed to generate heat. We've been doing deep litter bedding in our duck house now for almost 2 months or so, and I want to check to see how the composting is going. And now to do that, I have on loan from a friend a infrared heat camera gun. So we're going to take a look. Here you can see our ducks. They're all sort of huddling together. It's a really cold day. It's about 12 degrees right now here, about 1:15 in the afternoon. And as I'm looking at the ducks, look, you can see the heat of the ducks themselves. The white represents really hot. That's kind of cool. But as I'm looking at ground, I don't know, it's like 5 degrees, 6 degrees. You can see the temperatures here. Really the only heat in the hot spots, where it's like 30 degrees right there, but that's coming from the sun. So we have So that's facing west, and since we're just in the afternoon, the sun is shining right through. It's amazing how cold these birds actually are. I mean, outside right now, it's, I don't know, 10 degrees maybe, out in the sun. And I mean, just for your frame of reference to see what I look like, the heat that I'm generating, kind of cool, right? But it's remarkable when you look at the heat from the ducks. Kind of cool. But as I'm looking for heat and compost, I'm not really seeing much. Like, here's a spot. I can't just tell if that's just, I think that's just the sun, like where the sun's at. Ducks don't like it when I hang out in here. So I guess to answer the question, is my deep litter bedding generating heat? Clearly it's not. Is it composting? I'm not really sure. I'm gonna keep trying to turn the layers. I've done that once so far. Maybe it just needs more oxygen, but clearly my deep litter bedding is not generating any heat. So I would just throw that out there as a word of caution, because there's a lot of people who will make videos or write blog posts about this idea of using deep litter bedding to keep your animals warm in the winter. Based on what I'm seeing, there's no effect like that whatsoever. So, you know, take that for what it's worth. So that's been my experience with deep bedding. Maybe it's not for everybody. If you have a different experience, let me know down in the comments. And if you want to see a little bit more about how we keep our ducks in the winter, watch this video, or you can watch something else. Please be sure to subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next video.